We are actually in my studio right now, and I'm gonna take you through one of my tracks that I produced. This actually has a video which Certified UK actually blogged, and the reason why I chose to do this one was because this is probably one of the most interesting productions I've done. Even in the way it was made, it was very spontaneous and it was done very fast, but the outcome for me, I wouldn't say it's one of my best, but it's one that where I listen, when I listen to it, I do get great joy from it, and that's the Music Love Affair. So I'll take you basically through how I started it. It was a point in my life where I was really feeling jazz and breakbeats, and I kind of wanted to fuse the two. So basically, I started off with a Bill Evans sample. Was like it's a very nice jazz piece, but there were parts of it that I particularly liked, and there were parts that particularly stood out for me. So I basically chopped it up and found the bits I liked, which was like this chord here, and then so it was basically those three chords that I liked, and I chopped them up and kind of expanded them. And then, so I had that. Like I said, I was going through a phase where I was really feeling breakbeats as well. Excuse me, breakbeats. So, I had a breakbeat loop that I found, and I used that. So I put that together. Yeah, and then, what do I have here? I felt that it needed something odd as well, like something that you wouldn't expect to be on a record like this. That's like Mahalia Jackson, a very legendary gospel singer. Wish I'd be sky. Yeah, and then I added like my little percussion bits underneath to the breakbeat, because I like to always put my twist on things. I don't ever like to just have a breakbeat and then it's just that, unless it sounds good by itself, but I always still like to put something on it just to take that sort of ownership. So I had these little bits underneath and I put that. And then I had the piano sample as well. To just put out something without any vocals on it, partly because I don't want it to be a thing where I put it out on YouTube and someone steals it and dubs it and makes it their own, even though that's, you could say I'm being sampled, but I didn't have that kind of intention for that, or I didn't feel that was the purpose of this track. So I added my own vocals to it as well. Wishing this would last forever, playing with your strings, hands running down your frets. They don't understand what it feels like when your vibration's banging on my chest. The funny thing is I don't even play you, you sit there looking pretty at the corner of my room. Got a few sticks knocking at my door, I'll be back in a second, I don't mean to be rude. That's like the vocals and the drums, the solo, just to get like a better kind of listening preview of what I did. I like to use a lot of distortion on my vocals, simply for the fact that I feel like it gives it that sort of edge, as opposed to just having a clean vocal. Wishing this could last forever, playing with your strings, hands running down your frets. They don't understand what if. And I felt it kind of went with the kind of feel of the whole track, because the piano sample, you can hear like the little white noise coming in, which also gives it that old school feel. Wishing this could last forever, playing with your strings, hands running down your frets. And you know when you get those jazz recordings, you can hear that little sound, that's like old school recording. And distortion was also something that was quite frequent in those old school recordings as well, so I thought I'd put some distortion on my vocal. Yeah, that was basically done in less than an hour. I'm not one to like really brag about, oh, I did this in 5 minutes or blah blah blah, because I feel like, you know, it's not about the time, it's about the final product, but literally this was done so fast, and then the video was shot the next day. So it was really like a big experience, because you know, I just literally come in with no intention and left with probably one of my favorite songs that I've ever produced. So yeah, that's that process. That's Music Love Affair. You can catch the video on YouTube. Just type in Charm or Music Love Affair, and you can view that for yourself. It's an interesting visual as well. I mean, the visual definitely matches the song, and the song is really basically about, you know, my love for music and my love for the drums. But it's like almost like I have, you know, when like you love someone, but there's someone else that you find attractive, and then you could end up potentially having an affair with them. That affair came from that, with the bass guitar. Like, I actually really love the bass guitar, even though I'm not a bass guitarist, but I just love the instrument, you know, itself. So the video kind of depicts that whole scenario. It's very interesting, so you can check that out on YouTube. Yeah, you can download Music Love Affair off my SoundCloud, which is www.soundcloud.com/charmer808. It's also in the description below. Yeah, enjoy it.